Hi there. You are watching IndianExpress.com videos. Opposition's presidential candidate Meira Kumar today morning visited Sabarmati Ashram in Ahmedabad to launch her campaign for the election. She spent around 40 minutes at the ashram along with Gujarat Congress leaders Bharatsinh, Solanki and Shankersinh, Vaghela. Kumar said, and I quote, "My current fight is based on Gandhiji's principles. I've come here to gain strength from these principles and help disseminate the same. I wish from my heart that the most oppressed people of this region progress. This is what Gandhiji wished for, both for the nation and the world." Upon her arrival in Ahmedabad last evening, Kumar, who will contest against NDA candidate Ramnath Kovind in the presidential poll, said it was a battle of ideologies and not a Dalit versus Dalit fight. On Thursday, Prime Minister Narendra Modi too visited the Sabarmati Ashram to take part in its centenary celebration, which was home to Gandhiji from 1917 to 1930. For more news and updates, log on to IndianExpress.com.
Hours after Prime Minister Narendra Modi condemned the recent incidents of lynching in the name of Gaur Raksha, a man in Jharkhand's Ramgarh district was beaten to death on suspicion of carrying beef. Police sources said that Alimuddin Asghar Ansari was carrying the banned meat in a Maruti van. He was stopped by a group of people near Bajatand village before being brutally killed. Criticizing the Congress and left party decision to boycott the GST launch event at the Parliament Central Hall on June 30th midnight, Union Minister Arun Jaitley on Thursday hoped they would reconsider their stand and support the rollout. Calling GST as the single most important taxation reform in 70 years, Jaitley said the government remains committed to the goods and service tax as any other reform. Pakistan on Thursday summoned India's Deputy High Commissioner S. Raghuram to lodge a protest over an alleged recent cross-border violation by Indian Armed Forces, which they claim killed a civilian. A statement from the Foreign Office said that Indian forces resorted to firing in Nikai sector yesterday, resulting in the death of a 22-year-old civilian, Abdul Wahib, of Dotila village. Also, four other civilians were injured. Indian opener Smriti Mandhana struck an unbeaten century to guide her side to a convincing 7-wicket victory over the West Indies in an ICC Women's World Cup 2017 match on Thursday. The 20-year-old left-hander from Mumbai returned undefeated on 106 as India chased down a 184-run target with more than 7 overs and 7 wickets to spare. The Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences has issued 774 invitations to new members, and the list has been contingent of Indian actors, writers, directors and other celebs. The list of Bollywood actors is headed by Amitabh Bachchan, Priyanka Chopra, Deepika Padukone, Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, Irfan Khan, Aamir Khan and Salman Khan. However, Shah Rukh Khan is a major miss from the list.